Welcome, everybody. I'm Ginger Scraps.
I'm La Muerta, and we're here tonight with TXRD Lone Star Roller Girls, the first game of the season.
And we're bringing it to you in high definition on KCWX. This is the first game of the 2011 season for the TXRD Lone Star Roller Girls. Tonight we have the Holy Rollers versus
the Rhinestone Cowgirls.
It's going to be a game not to miss.
Wow! I am excited! Tonight is our first in-season bout, and you guys made it! Yeah! Are you guys ready for tonight? Okay, let me rephrase that. Are you guys ready for some roller derby? That's more like it.
So tonight we've got two announcers. Of course, Mike Whiteley, who's been with us forever.
Yes, and Wesley Page. So stay tuned. Watch the rest of the game. You're going to see some amazing plays.
Ladies and gentlemen, the two-time Covello Cup champion, Rhinestone Cowgirls! And now, the toughest girls on the schoolyard, the two-time Covello Cup champion, Holy Alrighty, we're going to do a little demo jam here to show you how it goes. Real quick, Wesley, up front. The jam cannot start till both teams are in formation. Up front, you have a pivot with a stripe on their helmet.
Well, that's right, and you've got four blockers behind the pivot. And behind the pack itself, you've got two jammers, but we've also got some people in stripes down there.
That's right. The jammers have the stars on the helmet. They are the point scorers here. You've got down the officials trying to keep some sense of order here.
Well, that's right. Then you've got the line refs on the outside that are going to also be looking for any penalties. Inside the track with the armbands on their hand with colors coordinated towards the teams, those are the point refs. If you watch them, they will hold up for that team how many points they've scored on that jam.
That's right. Also, they will signify which jammer is in the lead and lead jammer. The only person that can call off the jam is the lead jammer or the officials. Once the pack is in formation, there will be a single whistle signifying the pack can go.
Well, there's the whistle.
And with a double whistle, the jammers are let loose. Now the jammers must make their way through the pack. They will come back around and they will score 1 point for every opposing team player that they pass. That's 1 point for every opposing team player they pass. Now it's the blocker's job to assist their own jammers through and, of course, well, to block the opposing team jammer.
Well, that's right, Mike. They're not going to let them by. And as you said earlier, the lead jammer can call off the jam at any time by placing their hands on their hips.
All right, you got it?
I think they got it.
Like the pack is set. And we are off and rolling with the 2011 season. Ladies and gentlemen, on your feet, make some noise. As out in front and your lead jammer, the Gray Ghost for the Holy Rollers. She must stay on the track when she passes an opponent to score points. Wow, looks like having a little bit of problem at the back. And calling off the jam by placing her hands on hips, 0 points for the Rhinestone Cowgirls. First blood, 1 point for the Holy Rollers. Second jam as standards already going down. Looks like it's Rosie behind jamming for the Rhinestone Cowgirls. And after an extended absence, Truck Stop Trixie side by side working her way through the pack. And Truck Stop Trixie is your lead jammer. Wesley, Truck Stop Trixie having her baby, took off an entire season and a half. This is her first bout bath. I think we're gonna see a lot from her tonight.
Well, that's right, Mike. Not only had a baby, but by an Army veteran. And she is back in Austin, and she looks better than ever.
Truck Stop going for the full jam, but calls it off. 3 points for the Rhinestone Cowgirls. 0 points for the Holy Rollers in that jam.
Well, just like that, Truck Stop Trixie putting some points on the board for the Rhinestones. This is exactly what we thought was going to happen. The Rhinestones got some players back. They got some really good draft picks. And, of course, they've got the Dusty Double Wide Kitty Cat connection down there. We haven't even seen Category 5 yet. So far, Rhinestones up 3-1.
Looks like Gray Ghost jamming for the Holy Rollers. Second time, but it's the Norwegian Hurricane. Category 5 jamming for the Rhinestone Cowgirls. Looks like there's a little jammer on jammer action in a defensive move. Gray Ghost calls it off just like that. 0 points for either team in that jam. And the pack is off and rolling. Looks like Boy Division number 10 for the Holy Rollers and Kitty Sue for the Rhinestone Cowgirls. First jam for each of these skaters tonight. And out in front and your lead jammer, it's Boy Division. Boy Division, Wesley is from New York. She grew up on ice skates, making the switch to four wheels on each foot. Looks like she's got it down right now. as Kitty Sue going off the inside of the track, advancing as she got out through the pack, will not be lead jammer. So anyone's bout as we got a runaway Kitty right here with the Rhinestones way out, splitting up the pack. And we're out of time in that jam. 3 points for the Rhinestone Cowgirls, 1 point for the Holy Rollers. We've got our first major penalty of the night, Miss D. Toxin.
We have a major penalty on the Rhinestone Cowgirls. Number 40 volume, Junkyard Jess, for failure to yield. We will reskate the same jam set with the Rhinestone Cowgirls down one skater.
And we're off and rolling, first major penalty of the night. Rhinestone Cowgirls down one skater. This will, just like in hockey, gives a big advantage to the Holy Rollers. Boy Division out in front. Once again, Boy Division, your lead jammer. Wow, Notorious taking a hard there, polishing the Masonite. Because Anita confessed the captain, that big pileup down there. Skaters going down left and right as it's called off. 0 points for the Rhinestone Cowgirls with a skater up. Only 2 points for the Holy Rollers. Well, looks like we've got just over 4.5 minutes remaining as we're going to turn it over to our head referee, D. Toxin.
We had a major penalty on the Rhinestone Cowgirls. Number 5446, Diablo, for pushing. Since it's their second major penalty in a row, we'll move on to the next jam set with the Rhinestone Cowgirls down one skater.
Wow, it is a drag race out in front. And Abby Roadkill, her second jam of the night, is lead jammer. She grew up skating on eight wheels. She's got the pedal to the metal right here, showing her speed skating abilities. Getting taken down hard, but she's up as fast as she falls and calls off the jam in a defensive move. 0 points for the Holy Rollers. 2 points for the Rhinestone Cowgirls. Yeah, looks like we've got a minor penalty this time.
We had a minor penalty on the Holy Rollers. Number 1983, Grey Ghost, for tripping.
How's everybody doing out there? Man, I am pumped up. This is awesome. All right, let's see what we got. I can't believe we had two majors before a minor. You guys are doing great out there. Way to go. All right, here we go. Oh, I like it. Arm wrestling!
Well, this is a point loss penalty.
All right, it's category 5. All right, here we go. Let's give them some noise! Over the top! Yeah! Yeah! Yeah!
They are up to lose 1 point if they lose this challenge.
That is the way I like it, folks!
This.
Do it! Over the top!
Oh, we have a fault. Right, category so. 5 wins.
We had a point correction after that jam. The Holy Rollers should have two more points.
That brings up 6 points for the Holy Rollers, 8 points for the Rhinestone Cowgirls. We've got just over 4 minutes remaining in the first.
Here we go.
A rollergasm for the Rhinestone Cowgirls. And rollergasm out in front is your lead jammer. First jam ever for TXRD for Attila the Nun, number 406. She's clean of the pack, but rollergasm working hard to stay on 2 feet, running into the Holy Roller defense we've talked about over and over again. Going down on her knees, calling off the jam with 1 point for the Rhinestone Cowgirls, 0 points for the Holy Rollers in that jam. Gray Ghost out in front, getting through the pack first for the Alabama Song.
I know I can come near you every time.
Allie Bamazon, US 72, a rookie against the 2-year veteran Gray Ghost. Gray Ghost calls it off like a veteran would with 0 points for the Rhinestone Cowgirls. 2 points for the Holy Rollers. And the pack is off and rolling. Here come your jammers. Wesley, do my eyes deceive me, or is that Dusty Double Wide jamming for the Rhinestone Cowgirl? She's making a hole, she's breaking a... the whole wall of Holy Roller defense down. She is through, and your lead jammer. Abby Roadkill a little slow to get up right there. Holy Roller defense falling down right there. It's Boy Division back in the mired in the back of the pack. Dusty Double Wide looking for a little bit of help to get through the pack as she comes up into the Holy Roller defense. She's busting through, up and against the rail, calls it off. 4 points for the Rhinestone Cowgirls. Dr. Evil. And 0 points. And as the pack is off and rolling, Category 5. Still there, but it's Truck Stop Trixie out in front and a lead jammer for the Rhinestone Cowgirls. The Gray Ghost dropping back into a defensive position right here. She tries to take Truck Stop Trixie to the wall. Takes her down, but not into the rail. Truck Stop Trixie still rolling. Gray Ghost not even through the pack, relegated in the back of the pack, and called off by placing her hands on her hips. Calls off the jam with just over a minute remaining. 3 points for the Rhinestone Cowgirls. 0 points for the Holy Rollers in that jam. And we've got some laundry on the field detoxing.
We had two penalties on that jam. One major penalty on the Holy Rollers, number 1983 Gray Ghost for a forearm. And a minor penalty on the Rhinestone Cowgirls, number 777 Motley Sue for tripping.
Tripper. Bad, bad girl. I think I know what I want. Let's see what's gonna happen here. Does anybody want a pillow fight or something? I think I want a pillow fight. Let's see if I can get it to. Oh, it's a pillow fight! All right, you guys, this is up to you. I need everyone in here to pay attention because I'm gonna come to you and I'm gonna ask you guys who you think deserves and won the pillow fight. Are you guys ready for this pillow fight? All right, everybody know how a pillow fight works?
Pillow fight, come on Austin, Texas, make some noise. Who's gonna win this one? Remaining, the pack is off and rolling. Here comes Boy Division and Truck Stop Trixie. Definitely no love lost between these two skaters. Truck Stop Trixie advancing when she went through the pack. She's out in front but will not be the lead jammer. If she passes a skater getting through the pack, she must stay above the white line. She dipped down into the red and does not have control of this jam. Boy Division trying to get a little bit of help from her defense there with the Holy Rollers. Boy Division getting beat up, moving all the way, relegated to the back of the pack a second time. This one's gonna go all the way to the time clock, and Truck Stop Trixie is going for a double right here. Her first bout back. With TXRD, she's going for a double. Boy Division dropping back into defensive mode. Has nothing for us. We are out of time in that jam. 0 points for the Holy Rollers. 5 points for the Rhinestone Cowgirls. We're about to get going with our second quarter of the evening. However, Miss D. Toxin has a little laundry on the field.
We had a major penalty on the last jam on the Rhinestone Cowgirls, category number 5 for an illegal procedure.
And the pack's on the way, and here come jammers. Oh my. Little bit of extracurricular activity between two teammates in the back of the pack right there. And here we go. And it looks like our very own Abby Roadkill, the rookie sensation, is gonna try to put some points on the board one more time. Here she comes. Oh my!
And we're out of time in that jam of 2 points for the Rhinestone Cowgirls.
Well, Mike, we've been talking a lot about the Rhinestone Cowgirls tonight. Yet you can't not mention the fact, though, the Holy Rollers have got 5 rookies on the squad this year, and those rookies look really, really good. Mike, you got to get a season under your belt before you can really learn this game at game speed. Yeah! Well, just like that, Dusty Double Wide is out in front, and she is your lead jammer.
Mini Massacre, first jam tonight, 3 millimeters. Still making her way through the pack as Dusty Doublewide crashes through the front of the pack, having to start back over again. Mini Massacre still getting mired up. Wow, taking a huge hit right there off of Category 5. Category 5 showing she can play defense and she can put points on the board. Double D2XL going for the double right here. Working her second away. She's working the double as the time clock is still rolling. We're out of time in that jam. 0 points for the Holy Rollers. 10 points for the Rhinestone Cowgirls. Wesley, we've witnessed the first double of the season, right here, right now, with Dusty Double Wide.
Well, why not a double from the Double Wide herself? At this point, Mike, I'm looking at Dusty Double Wide's knee, and I'm saying, no knee, no problem.
No problem as Rollergasm lining up for the Rhinestone Cowgirls against Boy Division. Boy Division coming off a little bit of an injury earlier in the offseason with a big tussle as Rollergasm taking a hard end of the rail. Sissy Spankett taking out her own jammer right there inadvertently. Sissy Spankett looking good here tonight as Boy Division out in front and the lead jammer. Rollergasm trying to pull from the inside as the time clock continues to roll. Boy Division trying to find some organization as we're out of time in that jam. 0 points for the Holy Rollers, 0 points for the Rhinestone Cowgirls. We've got a penalty, Miss Detoxin.
We had a point correction from that jam. The Rhinestone Cowgirls should have received 1 point.
However, out on the track, Category 5, she spent a lot of time back in the back blocking. She's been on the pivot. Now she's back out front with a star on her helmet. And she is your lead jammer, the Gray Ghost. Got the pedal to the metal, doing everything she can to try to keep up with her right here. Let's see what happens as the Rhinestone Cowgirl defense tries to make a hole for her. A back elbow calls off the jam. Wow, Notorious with a little bit of a thank you nudge there. 4 points for the Rhinestone Cowgirls. 0 points for the Holy Rollers in that jam.
We had a minor penalty on that jam on the Holy Rollers. Number once a month, Bloody Peachka for a forearm.
Well, Bloody Peachka to the penalty wheel.
All right, what's going on here? Let's see what Bloody Peachka is deserving of. No. I want her to do this. Two
lap duo! Oh, snap!
This is a point loss penalty, Mighty.
That's right, Mike. And this is a no holds bar.
Two lap duel.
That means anything can happen in these two laps. Are you guys ready? Truck stop Trixie.
Now, Mighty, the only thing these skaters cannot do is cut each other's hair. I'm sorry, I misread that. The only thing they cannot do is cut the center of the track.
Okay, that's true.
Other than that, no rules.
Other than that, it's a no-holds-bar two-lap duel.
And we're off in skating. Yeah! Wow, Bloody Peachka taking her down right there with a bunch of kidney punches. Wow. Wesley, she's not new to roller derby. She's only new to us, and she's on the track. Give him Truck Stop Trixie what for right there. Let's see if Truck Stop can run her down. We said no holds barred. She's working a panty check as they're into the rail hard. And
whoa!
Looks like Truck Stop Trixie takes a very precious point away from the Holy Rollers right there, right now. That challenge. We're off and rolling with 4.5 minutes remaining in the first half as Rowergasm taking it high. Wow, trying to call off the jam. Attila the Nun, rookie skater, second round draft pick for the Holy Rollers. Out in front, checking up behind her. Abby Roadkill mired back in the pack. Cannot get through the Holy Roller defense. Wesley, looks like the Holy Roller defense is finally starting to gel 30 points later.
That's right, Mike. 30 points later might be a little bit late in this foul.
Well, never say never, but looks like Abby Roadkill finally through the pack. And we're out of time in that jam with 1 point for the Holy Rollers, 0 points for the Rhinestone Cowgirls in that jam.
We had two major penalties in that jam. One on the Holy Rollers, number 3, Candy Slam for a forearm. And one on the Rhinestone Cowgirls, number 6, Double 5321, Kitty Sue for a forearm.
Thank you.
There we go. Hey, rookie. That's the Abby Roadkill we were talking about before the bout, the only draft pick that the Rhinestones took this year.
Meanwhile, back to the action, Abby Roadkill. There's a reason why she's the number one draft pick right now, as she has got the speed and the grace as she approaches. Using her teammates to open up a hole. Lacey Bones not making it easy for her. There's 4 points on the board for the Rhinestone Cowgirls, 0 points for the Holy Rollers.
Welcome to TXRD, rookie.
Dusty double white, sizing up. Mini mic there, 3 millimeters. Mini massacre. As Ghetto Star Balactica going down, taking it hard on the knees right there. Dusty Double White going high, going low. She's all over the track, but she's out in front. Mini Massacre trying to keep up with her. Dusty Double White with an incredible move right there. Oh, and down off the inside of the track, calling it off. She might have gone below the white line, and she did, giving lead jam status to Mini Massacre. Mini Massacre runs the time clock down, trying to put some points on the board for the Holy Rollers, and she does. 0 points for the Rhinestone Cowgirls. 2 points for the Holy Rollers. Just about 2 jams left, as out there in front by about a half a mile, Kitty Sue making it look easy for the Rhinestone Cowgirls. Boy Division 3 of the pack. Boy Division grown-up skating has got the pedal to the metal, trying to make up all the time she can right here. Kitty Sue getting stung hard into the rail. Having to regroup, the pack spread out. And we're out of time in that jam. Could be Alabama's on there. Have a hard time reading that number, but I can read 4 points for the Holy Rollers.
We had a minor penalty on that jam on the Rhinestone Cowgirls. Number I-35, truck stop Trixie for a forearm. And we had a major penalty on that jam on the Holy Rollers.
Dang.
Number 0, Dot Stoyevsky for illegal engagement.
That illegal engagement. You redcoats know how I like that one. Truck stop! Way to come back, girlfriend! I like this one. Tug of war! Are you guys out there? Just checking. Just checking. All right, here we go. Little tug or war. Sissy, Rhinestone Cowgirls!
Well, there we go, Mighty. Let's go back to the replay on that one. You see Sissy grabs the rope and she tugs and she's like, no, you didn't. And then no. Battlestar Galactica says, yes, I did. And then,
like,
of course, Sissy Spank it won. Yeah.
And the pack is off and rolling. Here come your jammers with a misfire off of the starting block. Looks like Boy Division there with a miscue. West after Boy Division's injury, she seems to be not firing on all eight. Wow, but look at this. Out in front, it's Boy Division. I've just eaten my words. Right there, she's showing me a miscue out of the starting block, and she is out in front, and Boy Division is your lead jammer. Boy Division saying go, 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 trying to get old 406 going there. Attila the Nun. Wow. Taking down the front of the back. 1 point Holy Rollers, 1 point Rhinestone Cowgirls, and we are out of time in the first half.
With the score, the Holy Rollers 14, the Rhinestone Cowgirls 47.
All right, so that was some amazing action. We're about to go into halftime, so we'll be back after this commercial break and talk to some of the players.
Yeah, stay tuned. With Dusty Double Wide from the Rhinestone Cowgirls. And last time we saw Dusty, she got a little bit injured. So what's going on with that tonight?
Well, I took a bad spill in the last game, and I've been nursing it for the past 3 weeks. I haven't been skating very much, but we had bout practice last Thursday, and I was feeling pretty good. Starting off in the game, it's pretty sore, but you know, once your adrenaline gets going, it kind of gets knocked out. You don't have to worry about it as much.
She's tough.
Yeah, but getting hit in the eye in my first jam this game was probably what hurt way more than my knee.
So what are you guys going to do to stay on top? I mean, you're obviously very much on top for this game.
Well, we train really hard. We take our practices very seriously, but at the same time, we're really realistic about the fact that roller derby is supposed to be fun. And I feel like a lot of the times teams have a hard time balancing working really hard and having a really good time. And I think we do a really great job of doing both. And I think that's what keeps us normal, but also keeps us really competitive.
All right, we're here with the Grey Ghost from the Holy Rollers. Ghost, what the heck happened to your arms? Look at all this, all over her arms.
It is a rough game out there. It's rough.
Yeah. We're here at halftime. It's going to be a great second half. Stay tuned for the lots of hitting, lots of action. Rhinestone Cowgirls and the Holy Rollers. We're going to see who wins this one.
The rest of the bout being up by about 40 points so far.
Attila the Nun. No, I'm sorry, that's the Grey Ghost. Facing off. Oh, Dusty Double Wide going down hard in the first turn there, giving an advantage to Grey Ghost. Grey Ghost looking for a whip. Looks like she's working a panty whip, trying to stay above the white line as the pack is getting spread out a bit. Do a little bit of defensive blocking against Dusty Double Wide. And the Gray Ghost with the whip is out in front. And the Gray Ghost is your lead jammer. Wow, jammer on jammer action. Both of them taking each other out. Dusty Double Wide, the first one to get up. Motley Sue polishing the concrete off the inside of the track. If a skater goes off the inside of the track, the jammer passes him, they will still score a point as Dusty Double White calls off 2 points for the Rhinestone Cowgirls, 1 point for the Holy Rollers. Meanwhile, back in the pack, rookie jammer 406, Attila the Nun, first season for the Holy Rollers, first season with TXRD. Facing off against Truck Stop Trixie. She's working everything she can, trying to get through that wall of Holy Roller defense, working high tide, and she's out in front. However, with the referee's arms moving, she went below the white line. She advanced around another skater to get out in front and is not your lead jammer. Lead jammer, Attila the Nun. Attila the Nun dropping back into defensive mode back here. You'll see this happen sometimes as it's a jammer on jammer action. However, only Attila the Nun can call it off. Trick Stop Trixie on a flyer right here. She's got a full jam. This one's going to the time limit unless Attila the Nun can get through the pack. With a pile up right in front of the Rhinestone bench, which is usually a bad idea, they call off 5 points. For the Rhinestone Cowgirls, 0 points for the Holy Rollers.
We had a major penalty on the Rhinestone Cowgirls. Number I-35, Truck Stop Trixie for advancement.
Well, like I said, there's that advancement call. You have to stay above the white line when you pass another skater. And if you do that and don't return by going off the track and backing up behind that skater, you'll be called for advancement.
We have a point correction. The Rhinestone Cowgirls should have 53 points.
Uh-oh. Wow, that was really early. Never good when it's that early.
We had a major penalty on the Holy Rollers. Number 0, Dot Stoyevsky for tripping.
Mike, why them skaters be tripping?
I don't know, but they're going to the box.
Well, just like that, Miss Detox, and never a bad time to recognize the great officiating crew we have out there. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for the Zebras down there on the track.
They're having a tough job tonight. It's fixing to get ugly, but right now it's really pretty. With Abby Roadkill taking the high line. Now she's low right there in the middle of the track. Look at the speed of this skater, the agility. She's moving through the pack like a hot knife through butter into the lead jam position. Abby Roadkill, she could have my vote for Rookie of the Year this year. And making it clean. She's already working past the Holy Roller Jammer. Mini Massacre, she's working on her first double. Time clock rolling down, don't know if it's gonna happen. Going for her first double ever. Abby Roadkill in her first bout. Doesn't make the double. Does put points on the board with 0 points. For the Holy Rollers, 7 points for the Rhinestone Cowgirls.
We had a minor penalty on the Holy Rollers. Number once a month, Bloody Peachka for a forearm.
All right, Bobby.
Don't beat it to us.
just like everybody likes it, they want a pillow fight. All right, here we go.
Well, Mighty, I know that this is something that you do at every slumber party that you throw at your house. Ladies and gentlemen, the pillow fight.
Wow, she's got her in the Dutch oven right there.
Yes, she does.
First Dutch oven of the season, Wesley. Tappers apparently flying down there as we've got MSOs getting into it.
Oh, boy, division getting a little slipped up there in the beginning, Mike.
I know, a little bit of jammer action there on the jam line. Truck stop getting turned around hard into the rail. And out in front, and the yearly jammer by a nose. Trucks. Boy Division right beside her. Boy Division not letting her happen. Oh, no! Boy Division takes her own self out of the mix right there.
Get up front!
Lacey Bones saying, let's get it going here. Veteran skater over the Holy Rollers. We're out of time in that jam with 1 point for the Rhinestone Cowgirls. 1 point. 0 points for the Holy Rollers. All your information. And we're off and rolling. And out in front, first jam of the night for number 40, Junkyard Jeff. Veteran skater notorious. Co-captain of the Holy Rollers. Hot on her heels. Let's see if she can make up a little bit of time. The Holy Roller defense crumbling right here. Whoa! Junkyard Jeff taking out Notorious, falling off the jam just in time with only 1 point for the Holy Rollers, 3 points for the Rhinestone Cowgirls. Back to the action on the track, category 5, saving up for the best. Wow, she really did go through the pack like a hot knife through butter that time, Wesley.
Yes, she did, and here we go, category 5. Not seeing a lot of action tonight because the score's lopsided, but any time she's on the track, she is the best jammer on the planet today.
Alabama's on having a stellar evening out there. She's in the pivot position for the Rhinestone Cowgirls. Actually, Rhinestone Cowgirls in a bad position right there. Alabama's on way outside the pack. Lacey Bowden saying, let's get it going. Let's do the Hello Kitty and get out of here right now. Trying to get the ball rolling here for the Holy Rollers. Go, a leg whip. The first leg whip of the season off of Diablo. And we're out of time in that jam.
Ladies and gentlemen, you are in the eye of the storm. The best skater in the world. Category 5's a god.
And we saw the first leg whip off of Dill Dozer there. First leg whip of the 2011 season. Just 2 minutes remaining in the third right now as the pack is off and rolling. Here come a roller dancer. No, I'm sorry. That's Abby Roadkill. Wow, and Abby Roadkill, like she was shot out of a cannon, goes straight through the pack into the lead jam position. Almost outside of the track. The gray ghost, number 1983, stays on.
Yeah, here we go, lead jammer. Is it the back of the pack? Jam clock winding down to 17 seconds, called off.
Hey, Wes.
0 points for the Holy Rollers, 1 point for the Rhinestone Cowgirls.
We had a minor penalty on that jam on the Rhinestone Cowgirls, number 22, Rollergasm for advancement.
Wow. Rollergasm has been around forever. You guys, she is kicking booty tonight. Let's give it up for Rollergasm. Push cart, push cart, push cart, push cart. All right, here we go. Let's see if it does it. It might do it. Ka-ka, ka-ka, ka-ka. Push cart! All right, you guys, this is like, you know, push cart, and whoever wins, pushing each other around the track. Did you guys have a good time tonight?
Well, Mighty Aphrodite, this is just like what you and I used to do in the Kroger parking lot, except we use shopping carts. Let's see how they do.
You were the best.
Here we are.
You were the best.
The push cart and the one more lap to go. Wow. I don't think I've ever seen a push cart this close.
Holy Rollers. Holy Rollers, Ryan Snow.
Gonna have to wait for an official here.
Miss Detoxin.
Hello, Rhinestone! Numero uno.
And the two-time state champions, the guys in the orange shirts, they take care of us and they'll take care of you. Meanwhile, out in front, Boy Division is your lead jammer. Wesley, I don't know where she was the last rest of the bout. She is on fire right now. Four Division, your lead jammer by about a week, which is very unusual, being up against Category 5. Category 5 had a little bit of a slip-up. Maybe the Holy Roller defense has finally gelled. Four Division in a defensive move calls it off with 0 points for the Rhinestone Cowgirls, 1 point for the Holy Roller. Now are notorious knocking boots right there with Allie of Amazon, another referee, but out in front, Rollergasm with Grey Ghost hot on her heels. Grey Ghost is one of those standout skaters last year, making it to the Battle of the Bank, representing TXRD in her first season. She's been taking a lot of knocks earlier in the evening. Rollergasm dancing on the back of the pack right here. Looks like she's trying to bait some of the Holy Roller skaters there. She's really not being too aggressive. We're out of time in that jam. Diablo with a hard hit there on that last jam. And we're out of time. 2 points for the Holy Rollers, 2 points for the Rhinestone Cowgirls. Wesley, we're out of time in the third quarter. Tonight, but we are off and rolling as we start the fourth and final quarter of this bout, the first bout of the 2011 season, right here at the Thunderdome at Palmer Event Center in Austin, Texas, live. Bob Noxious, if you're still watching, turn the heater on because I know it's cold in Minnesota. Showtime dump truck. Everybody still out there, still watching? And of course, our attorney, Mr. Vince Hannity. I know it's a little an hour later over there in Florida, but if y'all are still watching, and anybody watching on the World Wide Web, you can reach us by email.
Well, that's right, Mike. You can reach us at the booth at TXRD.com. The booth at TXRD.com.
And it looks like Craig Ghost just running the time clock down on that one. As Double D taking it in there.
Wesley, what you got? Well, we have an email here from Mr. Owens. It's an exclusive love to our pivots and blockers like that.
Truck stop against first jam of tonight from Rosie Behind. I've seen moments of brilliance from Rosie Behind throughout the last couple of seasons, and you're seeing it right now as Rosie Behind goes straight right through the pack. Rosie behind, right through the pack. Oh, the scuffle already putting 1 point on the board right there. If the player is off the track, they still score the point. Looking for a whip right here. With a pack, a wall of holy rollers back there in the back of the pack, not doing them a whole lot of good. We've got a runaway kitty moving right now with the Rhinestone Cowgirls as we are out of time. 0 points. Well, actually, should be 0 points Rhinestone Cowgirls. Waiting for the official, but I saw 1 point with a skater off the track.
Well, Mike, we just got
there it is. There it is. 1 point. Holy rollers.
We have an ejection on the Rhinestone Cowgirls. For number 5446 Diablo for biting.
Well, Diablo will go right down to the Dunham Law Firm penalty box.
And we're out of time in that jam with 0 points for the Holy Rollers, 0 points for the Rhinestone Cowgirls.
We have a major penalty on the Rhinestone Cowgirls. Number 197666, Sissy Spank It for a forearm.
Hide your husbands because they might be the best team in the league this year.
Gotta get some cowbell out there. I need more cowbell, but out in front, like a rocket through space, a tandem with Boy Division and star skater Abby Rocha.
Oh, no.
Oh, she did not. Oh, no. She did, too. There's only so much New York girls can take, and you saw what happened right there, Wesley.
Right there, Mike, the rookie goes crazy and starts asking Boy Division, what do you got?
Do not mess with girls from Brooklyn.
Woo!
I'm telling you.
I haven't seen blondes like that since the Madonna Blonde Ambition Tour, Mike.
One more of those and you're going to have to separate them with a crowbar.
We had a major penalty on the Rhinestone Cowgirls. Number 40 volume, Junkyard Jess for a high block. Since that's the third major penalty in a row for the Rhinestones, they will lose 1 point.
Well, to the penalty box you go.
Notorious is out in front. Don't let her hear that.
Uh-oh!
Bloody Pishka mixing it up. Wow. Tempers are flaring, Wesley. You can see it right here. Bloody Pishka duking it out with Kenny Sue.
Well, Mike, not for nothing. If I was getting beat by 52 points, I'd be pretty pissed too, you know?
Well, many times tempers flare late in the bout. There is no holding back here.
We had two major penalties on that jam, one on the Holy Rollers. Number once a month, Bloody Pichka for unsportsmanlike conduct. And one on the Rhinestone Cowgirls, number 655321 for unsportsmanlike conduct.
Out in front, she's nothing but money, money, money. Also from Alabama, the Notorious is running the track right now. Allie Bamazon holding a close second, trying to make up a little bit of time. Notorious taking off the inside with an advancement right there. Loses her. Well, they called it anyway. Losing lead jam as she had an advancement right there. 3 points for the Holy Rollers. 0 points for the Rhinestone Cowgirls.
They just need a little bit more experience.
Oh, without a doubt. We saw last year with the Rhinestone Cowgirls. First battle of the season, we had a huge amount of talent out there. It was the skaters that are really kicking butt tonight. But the first couple of battles of last season, I mean, they didn't have the skates in the season. They didn't really know what was going on. You know, they never really met before. They had a huge amount of talent, which is seeing right now a year later. So this Rhinestone Cowgirl team started last year, just like the Holy Roller team you're seeing right now next year is going to be huge.
Well, Mike, you talk about the Rhinestones from last year. I mean, the Rhinestone Cowgirls got beat by the Putas del Fuego, and they don't beat anybody. And ow! Well, they haven't beat anybody for the last three seasons except for the Rhinestones.
Holly,
and there
Pino,
you go.
Don't listen to them. 3 points for the Rhinestone Cowgirls, 0 points for the Holy Rollers.
We had a minor penalty on the Rhinestone Cowgirls, number 40 volume, Junkyard Jess for a forearm.
Aw, what'd you do?
First minor penalty for Junkyard Jess.
Oh my God, I don't know. Where's Mighty? Who knows? What's your penalty? Judge's choice, pillow fight! Good.
Here we go!
Oh my. Ray Ghost facing off against Truck Stop Trixie. Truck Stop Trixie straight right through the pack, like a machete through pigback. Wow, I can feel that one all the way over here. Truck Stop Trixie out in front, working it still. Sissy Spankett lining up the whip into the back of the pack. And we're out of time in that jam with 0 points for the Holy Rollers. 3 points for the Rhinestone Cowgirls. Switch teams quite that easily. We are off and rolling. 2 jams left tonight. Hit is out. Abby Roadkill railed hard. Checked into the foot rail right there. Watch how she navigates all over the track. She's up on top, she's down below. She uses all the banking, she's out in front, and she's your lead jammer. Abby Roadkill is a skater to watch this season.
Here we go, we got the whip!
And in the middle of the action.
Wow, Mike.
Abby Roadkill breaks the wall of Holy Roller defense. Right there, goes right around him. Lacey Bones and Rosie behind. Trying to set up the defense. Did not happen. 0 points, Holy Rollers. 4 points, Rhinestone Cowgirls. Ladies and gentlemen, we have one jam remaining in tonight's bout.
This is my early candidate for Rookie of the Year.
Oh, I called that in the first quarter there. I'm quite impressed. Wow, hard rail there. Ray Ghost taking hard into the rail there. Hasn't quite recovered. Dusty double wide. My vote for Rookie of the Year last year, and she's shown so far why. She's been on a national championship soccer team in college. Came down here and thought she'd strap some skates on, and well, my golly, seeing what she can do right here, right now, she's continuing to put points on the board. She does not know how to slow down. She doesn't know how to stop it. But ladies and gentlemen, we are out of time in this jam. We are out of time in this bout. Ladies and gentlemen, would you please welcome to the track the winners of tonight's bout, the Rhinestone Cowgirls.
What an impressive bout, Mike. I gotta tell ya, if you're a Rhinestone Cowgirls fan, I comfortably can say the Rhinestones are back.
What a great game we had tonight. The Rhinestone Cowgirls really took it from the Holy Rollers. That was awesome.
Yeah, that was an amazing game.
We're here with Boy Division from the Holy Rollers. That was a crazy bout, huh? That looked like a really rough time.
It was really intense. It was great though. A lot of powerful hits from the Rhinestones, and I think we're gonna step it up next game, but you know, we're still new, and we're gonna start building more walls and come back at them, so they better be ready.
We've got Abby Roadkill here from the Rhinestone Cowgirls, the victors of this evening. Mm-hmm. Tonight was your first bout ever with TXRD. How was that?
It was intense. It was definitely intense. The Holy Rollers definitely brought it, and I feel like I was on the ground every 5 minutes, but I think we did well as a team, and it was my first bout, and I mean, I was just kind of literally rolling with it and trying to get through everything.
I think you were awesome. I mean, for your first game ever, that was incredible.
Thank you.
Yeah, she absolutely is a jammer to watch out for. And so who are you looking forward to really working with this season, out of the new girls?
Well, Minnie's coming up. She's doing really good. I see her as coming up and being a really powerful jammer. We got Attila. She's blocking really well. And Rosie. And who else we got? Ghetto. Ghetto's blocking really good. We just got to get everybody up to par, and everything's going to be awesome.
So a lot of new rookies getting ready for TXRD. I mean, really, that's a hard thing to do. So we'll see the Holy Rollers this season, and they're going to get a lot better. And this was a test of the rookies for sure tonight.
Absolutely. And you're going to see more of Boy Division, who is a jammer extraordinaire. Thanks, Boy Division.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you.
And the fighting, you got in quite a few scrapes there. Tell us about that.
Well, the first one was, I guess, a pillow fight. That wasn't really my fault. The second one, I got pulled down, so that wasn't really my fault. But I'm not going to let up.
So you're saying it's not your fault?
I may have instigated it.
Oh, all right.
That's right. Abbey Roadkill's about peace and love. We know that.
Okay, well.
With the killing.
We'll look forward to more peace and love from Abbey Roadkill with the Rhinestone Cowgirls. You guys are going to have a great season. I see it. I mean, championship. You guys are championship caliber for sure. So
thank you.
Good luck. And it was great to watch you skate for the first time. Awesome.
Thanks.
Yeah, congratulations.
Thank you. Good luck.
Yeah. So we've got Hades Lady from the Holy Rollers here. She's a retired skater. She is bench managing tonight. And that was a heck of a game. Hades, I saw some fighting out there. What was going on?
Oh, yeah. I think the Rhinestones really got our gall up. We really wanted to kick some butt, you know? It's really hard to lose. Nobody likes to lose, you know? And especially, you know, when the penalty ref is out there on the side of the other team. I mean, hello.
Yeah, you and Mighty have a long history together, being in the league for so long together. Yeah. That was a little scrap for you, huh?
Yeah, it was a little bit of a scrap. You know, Mighty and I like to mix it up just a little bit.
Especially with a bench manager like Hades. She will whip them into shape. We know that.
Yeah, may I remind you about the Rhinestones last season. They lost every game except for, the last one?
Exactly.
There you go.
Are you guys prepared for the rest of the season?
Yeah, we are. This was a huge learning experience for all of us. I think we're really looking forward to the rest of the season. I think by game three, you're going to see a whole new team. These girls are just learning. They're confused in the pack. They're going to learn how to play the game, and they're going to play really well. I mean, look at those jammers. Look at Attila the Nun. I mean, that's the first time she was even ever out there.
Yeah.
She rocked it.
Yeah.
We're here with Patty Hertz from the Rhinestone Cowgirls. She's bench managing yet another retired skater who's come back to whip her team into shape. Patty, tell us about the new girls this season.
Oh, they f***ing rock. Sorry. Yeah, they rock. I love Jess. I love them all, but really Jess is my favorite.
Oh, yeah?
Because she's scrappy.
Yeah. Well, you've been at TX30 for a long time. The Rhinestones have been through ups and downs, and it looks like they're on an up.
They've paid their dues. They have paid their dues, and they are ready to rule the world. Yes, they are.
I agree. I cannot wait to see what the Rhinestones have in store this season.
Yeah, that game was absolutely amazing.
They're going to show everybody a couple things.
I agree. Completely. Thank you, Patty.
Yes, thank you. This is fun.
And I can't wait to see the next one, actually. Yeah. My team, the Putas del Fuego, is going up against the Hellcats next time here on KCWX.